And now let's all play What's My Line?
I think I want the audience to know that the most delightful part of the show, Arlene, is always your introduction.
Oh, thank you very much.
But let me say to all of you, welcome to What's My Line. During the next 30 minutes, you'll meet some interesting people engaged in occupations which we hope will baffle our panel. And in addition, the panel will face a mystery celebrity guest a bit later on. But panel, are you all set?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's meet our first challenger. Would you enter and sign in, please? Peter Morrell.
Where are you from?
New York City.
New York City.
Right. All right, our panel, Mr. Morrell, won't you join me right over here?
Thank you.
All right, Mr. Morrell, I'm sure you know how to play our game, so let's let the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, I'd like to tell you that Mr. Morrell is salaried and does deal in a product, and let's begin the questioning with Arlene.
Mr. Morrell, is it a product that I might use?
Yes, it is.
Is it a product that one would have in the home?
Definitely, yes.
Yes.
If I had it in the home, would it be seen rather than hidden?
Yes.
Perhaps.
Is it edible or potable?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it a product that one would see at mealtime?
Yes.
Is it an accompanying product to a meal rather than the main course?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it, I don't know where I'm going.
It sounds good though, Arlene. It sounds real good.
Is it anything in the condiment family?
Now you're our expert, Mr.
No.
No, I would say no also, so that's one down and we go to Darryl.
Is it something that it is eaten either before or after the meal?
Before?
Oh, I have to say yes. Yes and no.
I would think that it is the type of thing that may be used in either case, but I'm going to give you a no, Darryl, because I think, generally speaking, this is a product that would not be eaten before or after as much as it might be taken of some other time. So that's two down, and we're going to go to Phyllis.
I see. Now, we haven't established whether it's eaten or drunk, have we? We
that
just know
correct.
It goes in your mouth.
That is correct.
Okay. If I brought this thing out at a dinner party, would I get oohs and ahs if it were good?
Yes.
Yes.
Now, I'm going to take a wild thing. Is it something you drink?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it in the alcohol and spirits division?
Yes.
Is it in the wine and spirits division?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it you do something with wine?
Yes. Yes.
Your product is wine?
Yes. Yes.
I have to find out what you do with wine.
That's correct.
You drink a lot of wine. What do you do with wine? You crush the grapes with your little toesies. I don't know. What do you do with wine? You bottle it.
No.
No. That's three down and we go to Gawn.
Hello. Do you never actually drink the wine? Must
no.
you spit it?
Is that correct? That would
that's
be a
correct.
No answer. So yeah. That's four down, and we go to Arlene.
Well, then are you a wine taster? Do you
yeah.
I'm a
very, very good. You know the Phyllis, the question that really threw me was, or Gawn's question that really threw me was, do you not swallow the wine?
That's correct.
And where
yeah.
have I heard
you
also that
out.
Wine tasters never really swallow wine?
That's
correct?
That's correct, except I've never spit out a bottle of the Lafitte 45.
And I want to tell you that Mr. Morrell is the youngest wine taster probably anywhere, isn't mm-hmm. that correct?
Well, definitely in America. I think perhaps in England they have some.
You just for young wines. They have
just
old wine tasters for old wines.
But he's a partner in Morrell & Company, which are importers and retail wine merchants, and you say you have sampled something like 30,000?
30,000 bottles.
Of wine. That must be very pleasurable.
Do you travel all over the world doing this?
Yes, I do. Mm-hmm. I go annually to France, Germany, Spain, Italy.
As a wine drinker, I'd like to ask a question. How do you rate, our domestic wines with the French wines?
I think they're quite good. Price-wise, you can certainly find a good bottle of American wine better than a good bottle of imported wine, and they're getting better every year.
That's our expert's opinion. All right, you didn't stump the panel, but you did get four no answers, and thank you so much, Mr. Morrell, for being with us on What's My Line. And we'll be back to meet our next challenger when What's My Line continues. Our panel, you did marvelously well on our first challenger. You all set for the next one?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Okay, well, our next challenger, please enter and sign in. Nancy Powers. Welcome to What's My Line. Panel, this is our panel, and Miss Powers, where are you from?
Memphis, Tennessee.
Memphis, Tennessee, all right. And won't you join me right over here, please? It's a lovely place. Okay, Miss Powers, I'm sure you know how to play our game, so let's let the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, I'd like to tell you that Miss Powers is salaried and deals in a service, but there's one other thing that I'll tell you before we even get started, that Miss Powers has a full-time job as a secretary at a medical advertising agency, so the job that we're, or the occupation that we're trying to identify is really her second job. So now that that is clarified, let's begin, and with Darryl Hickman.
Miss Powers, is your service, could it be used by both men and women?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it something that I would use?
Yes.
Yes.
In order to use your service, would I have to come to your place or establishment?
Yes.
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 I think so.
Do you wear any kind of costume or uniform when you perform your service?
Yes.
Would it be a costume rather than a uniform?
Yes.
Yes.
Would you... would we have any contact as far as touch is concerned?
No.
Touch, one down, and we go to Phyllis.
Thank you. Miss Powers, so you work during the day, then at night you go and change into a costume, and and I could come to see you or
yes.
Do what you do. Now, could it be classified in any way as entertainment or sports?
Yes.
Is it entertainment?
Yes.
Secretary by day and what by night? do you move your arms and legs in the costume?
Yes.
Is there music playing?
Yes.
Is it roughly dancing?
Or roughly dancing? Oh, and that's two down and we go to Gawn Granger.
Dancing, huh?
Do you use your voice with this music?
No, I think not. There may be times, that she would use her voice, but I've gone.
That's very unfair.
You are so persuasive, but still you get a no, and it's three down, and we go to Arlene Francis.
Do you use anything other than yourself when you're performing?
Yes.
Is it some sort of thing that you handle, that you use your hands on?
Yes.
Is it something other than a musical instrument?
Other than a musical instrument. And that's four down. You get a no, and we go back to Darryl Hickman.
Do you play a musical instrument?
Yes.
Is it an instrument not usually associated with the female sex?
I think we would have to say perhaps.
Is it an instrument that you hold in your hands?
Yes.
Is it something that you would blow?
Yes.
Is it, there are a lot of things it could be, all kinds. Is it a tuba?
No.
Tuba, five down, and we go to Phyllis.
It's something you blow, is it in the horn, it's in the horn family then?
Yes.
What do you blow besides a tuba? A saxophone?
No.
A saxophone? No, Gawn Granger.
You use your arms as well. A trombone?
Yes.
Yes! Let's see. Our guest, Miss Powers, is a trombonist, but now, does anyone have any idea where she might play the trombone? Just for fun.
In Memphis?
Not in Memphis. No, I'm sorry. She is a member of the Kit Kat band in Cabaret. But Miss Powers, you were not able to stump our panel, but you have consented to give us a demonstration of your art. So if you'd like to get ready, I'll tell the panel just a bit more about you as you're getting all set up backstage. Okay, I'd like to tell you, panel, that Miss Powers has been playing almost since childhood in high school bands and the Memphis Symphony. She's filled engagements at Reno and Harris Club and, you know, all many nightclubs. And she's going to be accompanied with her trombone solo by another member of the Kit Kat band from Cabaret, who is Mary Ann Burns. And they look like they're all set up and ready to go. And here is Nancy with the title song from Cabaret. Very, very nice. And you know, I think that we not only do we have one trombonist with us today, but I understand one of the members of our panel has played the trombone on Broadway. And that would be no other than one than Arlene. Arlene, please. Center stage. Someplace here I have another mouthpiece.
Another mouthpiece. And you're going to ruin my lip. My embouchure is no good.
Your embouchure is no good.
I've even forgotten how to hold it. It's been so long.
But now, before we start...
First, I want to explain to you that if you can blow a note, you're already miles ahead of anybody else.
But you've played on Broadway.
Yes, but I haven't done that for a year. And then I only played a note. It is difficult. Explain to the audience that it's very hard. Does anybody out there play?
Arlene?
I may not be able to...
Before you start, what will your selection be?
Oh, I'm not going to... My selection's going to be B-flat, if I'm lucky.
All right, here she is, Miss Arlene Francis.
Don't applaud yet. Wait.
I'm constantly amazed by your many, many abilities. Marvelous, Arlene.
I just want... It is marvelous, isn't it? And if any of you think that's easy... I'd like to ask somebody from the audience to come up here and do it, but we haven't got time. It's the hardest thing in the world to do, blow a trombone. You take my word for it?
You're going to break your arm, can't you? Thank you very much, Miss Powers, for being with us on What's My Life. We'll meet our mystery guest when What's My Line continues. Well, panel, you have a perfect score so far in our first game. And if you're all set, you know, it's mystery guest time. So are the blindfolds in place?
Yes. Yes. Huh?
All right, so let's meet our mystery guest. Will you come in and sign in, please? Panel, our mystery guest is here beside me, and I want to tell you that it's one question at a time. I'm going to give you 3 minutes to establish the identity of our mystery guest, and we'll start the questioning with Phyllis.
Well, from that applause, I gather that you are someone notable in the entertainment field. Am I correct?
No.
No.
Gawn Granger.
Well, then, are you notable in the field of sport?
No. Arlene.
Not noticeable. Is your name seen in the New York papers?
Yes. Darryl.
Are you notable in the world of politics?
Absolutely not. Phyllis Newman.
You're not in politics or sports or the entertainment world. What are you doing as the mystery guest? if I took this mask off, would I go, oh, my heavens, would I know your face? I would.
Yes.
Are you then involved, your face is well known, are you involved more from the directing point of view in entertainment business?
No. Mm-mm. Arlene.
Do you have anything to do with food and drink?
I eat it.
What?
Oh, well, our guest says he eats it, but I think your answer would be no, so we'll go to Darryl.
Are you in the newspaper world?
No.
Are you a newscaster, or do you have anything to do with the events of the day on television?
No. Gawn Granger.
Do you write books?
Yes.
Arlene? I thought books were entertainment. Maybe he writes textbooks. Are you primarily known as a novelist?
No. Darryl Hickman.
Do you have a book on the bestseller list at the moment?
No.
Too bad.
Phyllis Newman.
You are a man.
Absolutely. Yes.
That wasn't a question. That was just a recap. do your books have anything to do with physical activities?
No. Mm. Gawn Granger.
Are they funny?
Yes. Arlene.
Do you do a comic strip in the newspapers?
I know.
No.
You do?
Yes. Well, if you know, I will pass and let you tell me.
Okay, Phyllis.
Are you someone who used to appear on the show?
Bennett?
Yes!
I thought Arlene would get me right off the bat.
We were so worried, Bennett.
Bennett, in the long years I've known you, I've never heard you grunt before.
We were so afraid, Arlene, that you would pick
no,
it up
sir,
just
I
immediately.
Didn't. But when I said textbooks, I actually began to think about Bennett because he does publish textbooks as well as novels and every other kind.
I don't write them, though.
No, you don't write them. That's right.
Publisher of Random House, of course. Funny. And, Bennett, after 17 years of TV panel duty, how does Sunday night strike you now, you know, the show?
Oh, it's a very dismal night for me now. I put on my black tie out of force of habit. I prop up a picture of John Daly in front of me, and I cry like a baby.
But 17 years on What's My Line?
17 years with Arlene and John and the late Dorothy Kilgallen. And we used to have Fred Allen.
Yes.
About the nicest man I think I ever met. Those were great days, weren't they, Arlene?
Yes, they
I'm
were.
I'm glad to see you recreating them.
But you know, thank we you. Had fun with our mystery guest here. Have you had some? You used to have fun too, I know, with your mystery guest. Did you ever goof up or have any real problems with mystery guests when you were in the
family? Oh, yeah, lots of them. I can't begin to tell you. It'd take about 2 hours.
But you're famous, you know, for your quips on What's My Line. It was always kind of a treat on the show when they finally came around to Bennett Cerf, you know. You had something that you could just nail it, just like that. What is really your best and your worst? Could you give us two examples? You know, John used to kid you a lot about
the puns.
Oh, Bennett, your pun, you know.
I think a very good pun, and I don't want any comments from Arlene about this, or Phyllis, or the gentleman. There's a story about an undertaker in San Francisco who was unloading a coffin at the top of a hill, and it slipped out of the hands of the people and started careening down the hill. And they all ran after it madly, and they couldn't get up with it. So the undertaker rushed into a drugstore and said, "Can't you give me something to stop this coffin?"
Bennett, thank you so much for being with us on What's My Line. You know, we have a commuter with us on our panel, Gawn Granger. Gawn, where are you commuting from this week?
This week, I'm commuting from London. I flew in Sunday night, and I'm going to fly out again tonight. It's incredible.
Would you like to stay in this country, you think, permanently?
Oh, yes, I would indeed, very much. In fact, I've just spent practically 18 months here. I came here at the beginning of last year with the Bristol Old Vic Company playing Romeo.
Romeo?
Mm, all the Shakespeare. And then I loved it so much, when I got the opportunity, I came back again. In fact, I spent 2 weeks in London and came straight back.
But you're going now back to London, and I understand you're going to do a play there.
I'm going to do a play by Bennett Cerf called The Devil's Disciple. I'm going back to the classics.
Oh, that sounds marvelous. Sounds like you're very busy in London.
Very busy, and after that I do a picture called The Early Life of Stephen Hind.
Gawn Granger.
Great.
Well, panel, I think you did very, very well today. They did marvelously well. You got 3 out of 3, which you just can't top anyplace else. So that qualifies you all to come back tomorrow. And we'll see you tomorrow, too, on the all-new What's My Line?
What's My Line is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Miss Frances Downs by Bonwit Teller. This is Johnny Olson speaking.